The biggest democracy in the world is headed to the polls, with India's Prime Minister Narendra Modi the overwhelming favourite to win a third term in office. But on the ground in India, and increasingly in New Zealand, critics are raising the alarm about elements of his Hindu nationalist ideology. Fina Owen reports.
The Indian election is not only the biggest ever, it's probably inspired the most election musical numbers ever, all to get voters to the polls.
It's good, and if musicals help to deliver that message, then why not?
Murali Krishna Magasan heads Hindu Youth New Zealand. Like many Kiwi-Indians, he's keeping an eye on election news. But Hindu communities are also welcoming some news closer to home.
We're going to look for the land and build this place.
We're in Mount Roskill and this is Vinod Kumar. He's the former head of the Hindu Council and speaking on the council's behalf today. This weekend, the Temples Committee unveiled plans to build a Hindu youth centre in Auckland, featuring a 40-foot statue of Hindu god Sri Hanuman Ji.
So I said, hey, let's make up a centre and where youth can come to and be proud of it.
Recently, the Hindu councils had to bat off questions about whether a hardline form of Hindu nationalism, or Hindutva, is active in New Zealand. The ruling party in India, the BJP, has often been accused of silencing critics and subjugating non-Hindus. This last week, the hugely popular Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who's seeking a third term, sparked outrage when he described Muslims as infiltrators. He's been accused of turning a blind eye to attacks by Hindu vigilante groups on Christians in Manipur and hate crime against Muslims, Sikhs and lower castes.
So you don't think those attacks on Muslims or Christians happen in India?
No. If it has happened, it will be, you know, the news might be wrong. Sometimes they say, oh, they killed, this person killed that one. And then when we find out, it's not a Hindu. It's not, so they report it as somebody, you know. And this is how the media plays games with us. As I said, you know, Hindu, if you're following our Hindu way of life, we don't do such things.
This is the Hindu Nationalist Volunteer Paramilitary Organisation, the RSS.
So Hindutva, because I have to ask you about that, you don't think that has any elements in New Zealand? You know, they say the RSS, the paramilitary arm, that does not exist in New Zealand in any form.
There is RSS here. We call them HSS, Hindu Swayamsevak Sangh.
Yes.
Okay. So it's, you know, people have labeled it because they're trying to save the, you know, our people. Sometimes, you know, something happens, they go and actually rescue them. They don't have guns, nothing, right? But they teach, you know, our culture and our history and things like that.
And so they're trained?
They train them, you know, to be good nationals.
So thank you for meeting us after a whole day of meetings.
It's my pleasure.
It's quite dark.
The Hindutva ideology's biggest critic here is Professor Mohan Dutta. He says his employer, Massey University, has received letters of complaint about his Hindutva research.
Seeking to silence my voice. And these demands have taken various forms, all the way from demanding that I be fired from the university to needing to seek permission from Hindu leaders in the community before doing my research so that they could be the gatekeepers.
Jai Shri Ram to the entire Bharat.
He was critical of ACT leader David Seymour's attendance at a recent celebration in Auckland of the inauguration of the Ram Temple in India and the chanting of a slogan which has been hijacked by hardliners in India. The clip was picked up by Indian networks.
And on far-right Indian network, on their propaganda, that you have a New Zealand politician chanting Jai Shri Ram.
David Seymour said afterward that he repeated the chant to show respect for the traditions of the group hosting him.
Hinduism is New Zealand's second biggest religion, and like all of the world's major religions, there are various denominations and offshoots within it and beliefs among its adherents.
So welcome, Fenna. So this is the Rotorua Hindu Heritage Centre.
A growing Indian population has driven a demand for community meeting places like this. Murali, a young Hindu leader, is Rotorua born and bred, and like many young Hindu Kiwis, has re-embraced his cultural and religious roots. He partly credits the Indian leader Modi as instilling pride in being Indian and Hindu. He'd like academics here, who are critical of aspects of the Hindu Renaissance, to engage.
The academics genuinely want to have an honest conversation. It is not like we are hiding anywhere. Hindu Youth is there, Hindu Council is there, Hota Forum is there, so many Hindu organizations are there. You can approach any one of us and have an honest conversation. You choosing not to do that is up to you. People throwing shade, if that's their job, they are welcome to do it. But we go on doing our good work, and our work will speak for itself, really. So
you haven't come across any extremist element within kind of so-called Hindu nationalists in New Zealand?
I've not come across, honestly.
We feel threatened.
On the Kapiti Coast, we meet Oscar Fernandez, an Indian-born Christian who has helped set up the Alliance of Progressive Indians in New Zealand, a safe space, he says, for Indians, including Hindus, who are not comfortable with Hindutva.
Threatened in terms of not a physical threat, but threatening of your social life. You can be bullied, you can be sidelined, you can be discriminated on the basis of you're not aligning to the mainstream Hindutva nationalist politics.
Do you feel you have to be careful about what you say to
yes,
to who?
Definitely.
Q&A talked to several Muslim businessmen in Auckland who said they couldn't appear on camera, one claiming that his retail business had been intentionally boycotted by local Hindus. Have you heard that some Muslims here say that they are kind of targeted or their businesses
no.
have been boycotted?
Absolutely none.
Vinod points out that he and the council are part of an interfaith group with Muslims, Sikhs, Christians and other faiths.
There's nothing, absolutely nothing to fear from Hindus. Hindus are, you know, have been giving. They are givers and they'll be always giving. There's nothing to fear about.
Vinod Kumar is confident that on June the 4th, when India's election results are finalised, that he and his friends out in West Auckland will be celebrating Narendra Modi's return.